impact on access to food. A number of civil society organizations have criticized the IMF policies for their impact on access to food, particularly in developing countries. In October 2008, former United States President Bill Clinton delivered a speech to the United Nations on a World Day for Food Day, criticizing the World Bank and IMF for their policies on food and agriculture. "We need the World Bank, the IMF, all the big foundations and all the governments to admit that for 30 years we all believe it, including me when I was president, we were wrong to believe that food was like some other product in the international trade, and we all have to go back to more responsible and sustainable for the agriculture." Former U.S. President Bill Clinton speeches at United Nations World Food Day, October 16, 2008. The FPIF remarked that there is a recurring pattern: the stabilization of the peasant producer by a 1-2 punch of the IMF World Bank Structural Adjustment Program that gutted government investment in the countryside, followed by the massive influx of the subsidized U.S. and European Union agriculture imports after the WTO agreements on agriculture. Period open markets impact on public health. A 2009 study concluded that the strict condition resulted in 1,000 of deaths in Eastern Europe by the tuberculosis, as public health care had to be weakened in the 21 centuries. 21 countries to which the IMF had given a loan, tuberculosis deaths rose by 16.6% in 2009. In book by Rick Drowden titled The Deadly Ideas of the Neoliberalism, How the IMF Was Undermined Public Health and the Fight Against the AIDS, claimed that the IMF monetarist approaches toward the prioritizing price stability, low inflation and the fiscal restraint, low budget deficits was unnecessarily restricted to has prevented developing countries from scaling up long-term investment in public health infrastructure. The book claimed the consciousness have been chronically underfunded public health system, leading to the demoralizing working conditions there that have fueled a brain drain of the medical personnel, and all of which has undermined public health and the fight against the HIV, AIDS and developing countries. In 2016, the IMF Research Department published a report titled Neoliberalism Overshadowed, which, while praising some aspects of the new liberalism agendas, claimed that the organization has been overselling fiscal austerity policies and the financial deregulation, which they claim has exacerbated both financial and crisis and economic inequalities around the world. Impact of the environment. IMF policies have been repeatedly criticized for making it difficult for the indebted countries to say no to the environmentally harmful projects that nevertheless generated revenue, such as oil, coal and forestries, destroying lumber and agriculture projects. Ecuador, for example, had to defy IMF advice repeatedly to pursue the production of its reinforced forest, though the paradoxically this need was cited in the IMF argument to provide support to UCDR. The IMF acknowledged this paradox in the 2010 report that they proposed the IMF Green Fund and mechanism to issue specially drawing rights directly to pay for climate harm prevention and potentially other geo-ecological protection, and as pursued generally by other environmental finance. While the responding to these moves was generally positive, possibly because ecologically protection and energy and the infrastructure transformation are more politically neutral, the pressure to change the social policy, some experts voiced concern that the IMF was not representative and that the IMF proposal to generate only $200 billion a year by 2020 with the SDR as a seed funds did not go far enough to undo the general incentive to pursue destructive projects inherited in the world commodity trading and the banking system. Criticism often leveled at the World Trade Organization and large global banking institutions in the context of the European debt crisis. Some observers noted that Spain and California, two double economies within the Europe and the United States, and also Germany, the primary politically most fragile supporter of the Europe currency, bailout would benefit from the IMF recognition of their leadership in the green technology and directly from the green fund generated demand for their export, which could also improve their credit rating.